And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Cedarosaurus, which was a request from Lainey Powers, so thanks. It was a brachiosaurid sauropod that lived in the Cretaceous in what is now Utah in the U.S., and it was described in 1999 by Tidwell, Carpenter, and Brooks. The name means cedar lizard, you may have guessed. It was named after the Cedar Mountain Formation where it was found.
See, it's not just China that does that.
It's not, no. And the type species is Cedarosaurus weiskopfae. I think that's how it's pronounced. But the species name is in honor of Carol Weiskopf, quote, for her hard work in the field and lab. The fossils were found from at least three individuals. It's similar to the Brachiosaurid Eucamerotus from southern England and Brachiosaurus from the Morrison Formation in the U.S. Cedarosaurus is related to Venenosaurus, but it was more gracile, especially the forelimbs. Cedarosaurus was herbivorous, and it was medium-sized for a brachiosaurid. It was probably a tall browser, like other brachiosaurids, which would allow it to live among other herbivorous dinosaurs, so it could reach up high for its food, basically. Many gastroliths have been found. Those are those smooth stones that they use to digest, to help with digestion.
Yeah, grind up that plant material.
Mm-hmm.
Do a nice, tasty mush.
Yes.
Easily digestible, at least.
And Frank Sanders, Kim Manley, and Kenneth Carpenter did a study in 2001 of 115 gastroliths from Cedarosaurus. They were found near the skeleton with signs that it was still in the dinosaur's body while it still had soft tissue.
I think that's mostly like acid etching is what they look for.
Maybe the smoothness too.
Yeah.
These gastroliths weighed 15 pounds or 7 kilograms total.
Wow.
Yep. Most were spherical, though some were large and had irregular shapes, which would have been hard to swallow.
Oof.
And this means Cedarosaurus either liked these for some reason or just didn't really care about the shape.
Or they just weren't that smart.
Hard to say. But as we mentioned, the gastroliths either helped to grind or crush the plant matter.
Yeah, gastroliths are really interesting. How you put them in a gizzard, it's like a big muscle that contracts and can grind up food.
And also how long it would have taken to digest.
Yeah.
Basically turn the plant matter into some kind of stew inside.
Yeah, it helps if you grind it up real finely first,
mm-hmm.
especially since they didn't really chew their food.
Yeah, so good call, Cedarosaurus. For those of you who listen to our Dinosaur of the Day segment and you like it, please consider becoming a patron. We take new Dinosaur of the Day requests from our patrons and offer a bunch of other perks as well. So check out our page at patreon.com/inodino or click the link on the left.